Our dear viewers and listeners, greetings to you in the precious and wonderful name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We thank the Lord for today. For indeed it is the day that He has made. And we shall rejoice and be glad in it. Today, as we kick off our Bible study, let's dedicate this moment to God in prayer. Let's pray.
Precious Lord, we thank you.
Yes, Lord.
What a great God and Savior you are.
Yes, Lord.
Indeed, you are on the throne. Our hearts rest in that assurance.
Yes, Lord.
That indeed Jesus is ours.
Yes,
the blessed story of our life. That indeed God is at work in us, both to do and to will.
Yes,
such an amazing grace we celebrate.
Yes,
Spirit of the living God, we welcome you.
Yes,
let your presence prevail in this place.
Yes,
let your word be exalted in our midst.
Yes,
reign in us, King of glory.
Yes,
Father, we step aside.
Yes,
that you might take preeminence.
Yes, Lord.
And reign in all things.
Yes, Lord.
Touch us.
Yes.
Touch everyone.
Yes, Lord.
Heal.
Yes.
Deliver.
Yes, Lord.
Restore.
Yes, Lord.
Uplift.
Yes, Lord.
That the glory, the honor, the power and the praise indeed returns to you alone.
Yes, Lord.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Today we are continuing with where we left off last week. As we look at the judgments of God that will happen on the ungodly at the close of the age, we have seen the Lord unlock the seals. And there we saw the wrath of God revealed upon the ungodly. We saw the wrath of God further poured out when the trumpets were sounded. And now we get to the third phase, which we began last week, of the bowls poured out. Seven bowls. So we take it back a little bit,
tugenda kudilira emabegako,
and we will pick it up from verse 12.
Tutandikire mu lunyiriro lwa 12,
where we saw the river Euphrates being dried up.
Wetwalaba omugga Fulati nga gukalidde.
And let's read.
Tusomere wamu.
The Bible says,
Bible yegamba,
then the sixth angel poured out his bowl,
malaika omukaga naiwe mu bakuli ye,
on the great river Euphrates,
eri ennyanja nene ya Fulati,
and its water was dried up,
ne kalira,
so that the way of the kings from the east might be prepared.
Okuteekateekera ekkubo ly'abakabaka abava ebuvanjuba.
And I saw three unclean spirits like frogs coming out of the mouth of the dragon.
Ne ndaba emyoyo emikyamu ng'ebikere nga biva mu mumwa gw'omusota.
Out of the mouth of the beast.
Omumwa gw'ensolo.
And out of the mouth of the false prophet.
N'okuva mu mumwa gwa nnabbi ow'obulimba.
For they are spirits of demons.
Gino myoyo gya dayimooni.
Performing signs which go out to the kings of the earth and of the whole world to gather them to battle of that great day of God Almighty.
Gikola obubonero obugenda eri bakabaka b'ensi n'ensi yonna okubakuŋŋaanya wamu ku lunaku olukulu olw'olutalo lwa Katonda ow'amaanyi.
Behold, I am coming as a thief.
Laba nzijjanga omubbi.
Blessed is he who watches and keeps his garments.
Awereddwa omukisa atunula akuuma ebyambalo bye.
Lest he walk naked.
Aleme okutambula bwereere.
And they see his shame.
Balabe ensonyi ze.
And they gathered them together to the place called in Hebrew Armageddon.
Ne bakuŋŋaanyira wamu kifo mu Lwebbulaniya eriyitibwa Amagedoni.
Then the seventh angel poured out his bowl.
Malaika omusanvu naiwe bakuli ye mubanga.
And a loud voice came out of the temple of heaven.
Eddoboozi eddene ne liva mu yeekaalu y'eggulu.
From the throne saying,
okuva ku nnamulondo nga lyogera nti,
it is done.
Kikoleddwa.
And there were noises and thunderings and lightning.
Ne wabeerawo okuleekaana n'okubwattuka n'ebimyanso.
And there was a great earthquake.
N'ekikankana ekinene.
Such a mighty and great earthquake as had not occurred since men were on the earth.
Ekikankano kyali kyamanyi nnyo nga tekirabikwangako okutandika ensi bwe yatondebwa.
Now the great city was divided into three parts.
Ekibuga ekinene nekyawulwamu mu bitundu bisatu.
And the cities of nations fell.
N'ebibuga by'amawanga nebigwa.
And great Babylon was remembered before God.
Ne Babylon omunene najukirwa maso ga Katonda.
To give her the cup of the wine of the fierceness of his wrath.
Okumuwa ekikompe ekyekiruyi ekyobusungu bwa Katonda.
Then every island fled away.
Buli kizinga nekiduka.
And the mountains were not found.
N'ensozi nezitalabirwako.
And great hail from heaven fell upon men.
No muziro omunene okuva mu ggulu ne gugwa ku bantu.
Each hailstone about the weight of a talent.
Nga buzito bwa talanta.
Men blasphemed God.
Abantu ne bavvoola Katonda.
Because of the plague of the hail.
Olw'ebibonyoobonyo by'omuzira.
Since that plague was exceedingly great.
Kubanga ekibonyoobonyo kyali ky'amaanyi nnyo.
What do we see in this text?
Mukyawandikibwa kino tulaba ki?
We now see the sixth and the seventh bowls being poured out.
Tulaba ebbakuli ey'omukaaga n'omusanvu nga ziyiwayo.
Whatever is happening,
byonna ebiriwo,
is happening in quick succession.
Bigoberegana.
And I understand when we talk about the judgments of God.
Tegeranga twogera ku misango egya Katonda.
To many Christians, this is not something they want to think about.
Abakristo abangi kino ekintu tebakyettanira nnyo.
We don't put verses of God's judgment on sticky notes and put on our cupboards.
Tetutera kuziwandika mu mayumba gaffe ne tuziteeka ne mu bitabo.
We don't try to commit these scriptures to memory.
Tuzeewala nnyo okuzikuuma mu birowoozo byaffe.
Many of us would choose not to listen to a someone on God's judgment.
Era abasinga tebatera kuwulira njiri ekwatagana n'emisango Katonda gyasala.
But what we fail to see,
naye kye tutalaba wano,
is that the love of God,
okwagala Katonda kwalina,
has no meaning whatsoever,
tekuina makulu,
unless we understand the judgment that we were saved from.
Mpozi nga tumaze okutegeera emisango gye twawona.
We cannot understand the extent of the fullness of God's love for us.
Tetusobola kutegeera ekigera n'obujjuvu bw'okwagala Katonda kwayina gye tuli.
Until we come to a place,
mpaka we tutuuka mu kifo,
where we understand,
ne tutegeera,
what will befall those,
ekijja okugwa kwabo,
who will not heed to the love of God.
Abagaana okutwala okwagala kwa Katonda.
So the judgment of God,
kati emisango Katonda gy'asala,
reveal the fullness of God's love for us.
Gitulaga obujjuvu obw'okwagala Katonda kwayina gye tuli.
Because if it were not for his grace and love,
singa si kisa kye n'okwagala kwalina,
everyone deserved that punishment. Everyone deserved that judgment. And it is at that point that we then understand such love, so great, such love, so mighty, such love, so deep.
Okwagala okugende buziba.
The love that demands.
Okwagala okusaba.
The love that deserves.
Okwagala okugwanira.
A response from you and I.
Fenna twanukuleje
kuli. That have come to the saving grace of Jesus Christ.
Abaze eri ekise ekyatulokole kya Yesu Kristo.
Here we see that the judgments of God.
Wano tulabe emisango Katonda gy'asala.
Is limited. It is limited to everyone that has received the mark of the beast and has received the image of the beast. So everyone that has now submitted themselves to the devil will be a target of the judgments of God. Also, last week we saw that the judgments of God will not only go to the people, but they are also going to target Babylon. And Babylon will understood it as the false church that will occupy that time.
Twajitegeranga kanisa eyobulimbe eribawo mu biseere
ebyo. That will have a wing of commerce.
Eribamu ebyenfuna.
But also have a political wing as well.
Nenge erine mu byobufuzi.
All merged together.
Ngebigasse wamu.
With the chief architect now being the false prophet.
Ngomukuru wacho yenabyo wobulimba.
Who will represent the beast?
Ngachikirire ensoro.
Who represents the dragon?
Ngachikirira
Ogusota. So we have this trinity
that
will be in full operation during this time.
And
it is here then that we see the sixth angel pour out his bowl on the great river Euphrates. And the Bible says the water dried up. And the purpose of this happening was to prepare a way for the kings from the east to cross and come to this place called
Armageddon.
Now it is here that we see the behind the scenes operations of this unholy trinity. John tells us that he saw evil spirits that looked like frogs that came out of the mouth of the dragon, that came out of the mouth of the beast and out of the mouth of the false prophet. So these were spirits of demons performing miraculous signs, and they go out to the kings of the world. They go out to the people of influence of the world. They go out to the people that call the shots in the world. They reach out to the men and the women of that time who have the means to influence others, with the purpose of gathering them for battle on the great day of the Lord God Almighty. Now this is a very interesting one, because the Bible holds it at that point and then takes us into an interjection. Then a voice from heaven is heard, and it is the voice of the Lord himself. You see, if we look back, we see a number of series happening. And always between the sixth and the seventh movement, there is a pause. This one is the shortest, because this pause is one verse long. It is verse 15 where Jesus speaks and says, "Behold, I come like a thief. Blessed is he who stays awake and keeps his clothes with him, so that he may not go naked and be shamefully exposed." Listen what he says. He said, "Behold, I come like a thief." This gives us reference to what Paul alluded to in the first book to the church in Thessalonica, chapter 5, from verse 1 to 3, he writes and says, "Now, brothers, about the times and the dates, we do not need to write to you. For you know very well that the day of the Lord will come like a thief in the night. Why people are saying peace and safety, destruction will come on them suddenly, as labor pains of a pregnant woman." And he concludes by saying that they will not escape. naba kakasanti tewali ali chiwona. There will be no escape for them.
Teri kuchiduka chiwona.
Everyone that is a target.
Buliomu
age. There will be nowhere they run to.
Ngateri chidukido.
This seems to be the same scene.
Era kino kirabikanga chechimu.
That Jesus captures.
Yesu yachogera.
So now we have a behind scene.
Kati batulage chiri eliye mabega.
The purpose of his coming.
Ekigendere ekyokumuleta.
Is announced here.
Bachiranga wano.
It is to remove, to strip off all garments of hypocrisy.
Kujjako ebyambalo ebyobunafuusi byonna.
By which men have clothed themselves throughout time.
Abantu be bazinga beekweka mu mirembe na mirembe.
So those that will parade themselves as the wise.
Abajjo okweteeka maaso ng'abagezi.
Are going to be stripped.
Naked.
The powerful will be stripped
naked.
The rich will be stripped naked. Every category that you think wows right now. The things that you admire. If they have not been of God. If it is not the work of God. It is going to be stripped away. And the Bible says, blessed is he who keeps his clothes with him. So that they may not go naked. In that day, the purpose of his coming is to strip away every garment of hypocrisy. In that day, if you are not clothed with the garment of righteousness that he has given you, you are going to be exposed. We don't know the day, we don't know the time. But right now is your moment for you to receive that garment of righteousness. The righteousness that we obtain by faith in Jesus Christ. It is not a righteousness of works. It is a righteousness that we receive because we have believed on the Lord Jesus Christ. That is very profound. And then the Bible goes back to tell us what will happen. The judgment that will happen after this river has dried up. So the kings from the east will come. Possibly that will, those will be the nations of India, China, and Japan and so on.
Galiba mawanga aga Asia abayindi aba Japan na aba China.
These will be the nations that will now be the superpowers from the east.
Ganamange gajjo kubaga amanye yo evanjuba.
We are going, we will see them also meeting those from the west.
Ngagasi sinkana naga agave
bugwanjuba. And they will come together.
Vegate wamu
in this place.
Muchifo
to battle. But what we see are the unseen forces that are manipulating or orchestrating all these events. In chapter 9, we get a peak that over 200 million will gather. For battle, this will be like a world war. Actually, it will be a world war. That but all enemies will come. And initially they will contend with one another. But ultimately it will be a battle against Israel. It will be a battle to conquer Israel. But even that one will not come to any fruition. It will be an unsuccessful one. For the Bible tells us Bible that the seventh angel poured out his bowl in the air. Now you notice the tense that is being used. This is a prophetic book. Whatever they are saying right now has not yet happened. It will happen in the future. Yet when they are, John is recording this, he's recording it in the past tense. He's not saying the angel will pour. He said the angel poured. This points to the certainty of these events occurring. And this points to the certainty that evil will not triumph in the end. Evil will not have the last say. Because the Bible tells us that when the seventh angel poured his bowl into the air, out of the temple came a voice saying, it is done. It is the word we had, we saw the last time round. Tetelestai. Similar to the word Jesus pronounced on the cross in John
19:30.
When with his hand stretched out, he said, it is finished. Even now, this same word will be said.
It is done.
The final judgments will be unleashed. And God will pay in full to everyone that chooses to side with evil. It is done means that the devil,
Satan,
will not anymore have any influence on the earth. His forces will be annihilated. This is what the Bible says. When the angel poured out the seventh bowl, flashes of lightning, there was thunder, and there was an earthquake so severe like it has never happened on the face of the earth. The earthquakes were usually the big ones that we see usually read around 8-9 on the Richter scale. That is enormous earthquake. But this one is going to be so severe. The Bible says no earthquake has appeared like it on the face of the earth. This will split the city of Jerusalem.
Kino kijja kwawulamu ekibuga kya Yerusalemu.
It will collapse.
Kijja kugwa.
This great city that will have been rebuilt.
Ekibuga ekinene kibajja okuzimba.
Will collapse.
Kijja kuyika.
And the Bible goes on to tell us,
Bible yetukakasa,
that God remembered Babylon the Great.
Ate Katonda najjukira Babylon ekinene.
He now turns his attention to this great city of Babylon, to the entire system that has been ruling the world. And in the next chapters, we are going to see how his wrath will be unleashed in detail on these cities. But also we note that when this is happening, cities are going to go down. Mountains are going to be leveled. Islands are going to disappear. It will be havoc like never seen on the face of the earth. It will be turmoil like nobody ever knows. Quantifying it economically would be so enormous. When you look at islands disappearing, when you look at mountains being leveled, when you look at pieces of the earth moving to and fro, why? Because of an act of only one angel. You see, today we talk about the superpowers. Which country has the greatest military power? We're talking in terms of hundreds of thousands of soldiers. But that is of no consequence in the heavenlies. One angel with a bowl, not a sword, a bowl, powers that bowl, and the impact is so devastating that it marks it erodes cities, it removes mountains, it changes everything that we see and know. Yes, we know there is the nuclear and what nuclear power can do, but that pales when you read the Bible and see what one angel, not with an atomic bomb, not with nuclear ballistic missile, one angel with a bowl and just pouring that bowl brings so great a devastation on earth. And the Bible says hailstones came down. Huge hailstones, heavy. And they fell on the heads of men. You think it is only armies of this world that have snipers? When you look at this, this is like snipers from heaven. Hailstones that are coming down. Huge hailstones hitting on men. And the Bible says when it came upon them in judgment, the Bible says this plague was so terrible. And on account of this, the people blasphemed God. They cursed God. And this is amazing. Because all this is happening, it is a statement from God. Like we saw last week, these men of that time will understand the origin of this. Because whereas the Antichrist, who is the beast, and the prophet, and the dragon have gone out with signs and wonders to deceive the kings of the earth, all their power combined cannot stop any of the judgments that are coming from God. They cannot reverse anything that God has destined upon
them.
They cannot be able to protect their people. If you read Zechariah 14, as a result of this, the Mount of Olives will split into a half. One part will move to the north, and one part will move to the south, and there will be a valley created. So that the geography or the topography of everything on earth is going to be changed by this one event. That when that time comes, we will see those that will be here will see something they have never seen. But what do we see as a result? We see an increased hardening of people's hearts. Now you may ask, why is that so? What is this intended for us today? You see, the judgments of God are not intended to produce repentance. God's judgment does not, cannot, it is not intended for producing repentance on earth. Listen to what Paul says. Romans chapter 2.
Barumi sura yo
ku verse 4.
Olinyiriyo rwokuna.
Paul says.
Paul agamba.
Do you not know
temumanyi
that God's kindness
ti ekisa katonda chaina
is meant to lead you to repentance?
Chikukulembere wene nye.
So it is not the judgment that will cause us to change our mind.
Emisango yisizi yajituletera okuchusa endowooza zaffe.
Men are often stubborn.
Abantu baddalu bajemu.
And set themselves to do more evil.
Bewayo okweyongera okukola obubi.
When judgment is released.
Nga babasalira emisango.
So what causes men to turn?
Kyekireetera abantu okwenenya.
It is God's grace.
Ekisa Katonda kyaleeta.
It's God's love.
Okwagala kwa Katonda.
It's God's mercy.
Okusaasira kwa
alina. And that is being poured out every day of our lives.
Akuyiwa bulijjo obw'obulamu.
The Bible tells us.
Bible yegamba.
That the mercies of God.
Okusaasira kwa Katonda.
Are new every morning.
Kupya buli lunaku.
This is an exciting scripture.
Ikyawandikwa kino kya muwendo.
Because what that means.
Amakulu gacho.
Is that God will not.
Katonda tasobola.
Use yesterday's mercy for today.
Okusasira kwa yakozesezo lunaku rajjo takukomya olero nge gogo.
Every new day,
bwirunako
rupya. God releases new mercies.
Asumulolo okusasira okupya.
Now, mercy applies when you're guilty.
Okusasira kujja eri omusango gwe gusinze.
To the guilty, it is only people who are guilty that ask for mercy.
Abantu omusango gwe basinze bebasaba ekisonyiwo.
So if I'm not guilty, there is no way I can ask for mercy.
We gubate gusinze mba setaga kusasira.
But the moment I'm appealing to mercy, that means I'm guilty.
Newe mba nonyo okusasira kitegeeza nazizo omusango.
So what does it mean?
Kitegeeza.
The Bible tells us that the mercies of God.
Bible egamba ekisa n'okusasira kwatonda kwaina. Kubera kupya.
Every morning.
Buli lunaku.
Think about that.
Gendo fumitirizeko.
Isn't that enough for you to change your heart?
Echo techikumbala gwe wenenye.
Because if God's mercy cannot appear to you.
Okusasira kwena yokuba tusobola kukolera.
If God's grace cannot appear to you.
Ekisa kya Katonda kisobola kuyamba.
If God's love cannot appear to you.
Okwagala kwena nga tusobola kuchusa.
Because the Bible tells us that of his fullness have we received grace upon grace.
Bible okuva mu bujjuvu bwaina twaweebwa ekisa kukisa.
That is referring to Jesus Christ.
Nga boogera ku Yesu.
He gives us mercies anew every morning.
Atuwe ekisa bulijjo.
And of the fullness of Christ.
Ne mu bujjuvu bwa Christ
we receive
twaweebwa.
In other words, we are recipients not by works, we are recipients by grace.
Tuweebwa lwa kisa si bikolwa byaffe.
It is not merited.
Si biki byetukoze.
None of us deserves this.
Teri agwanira.
But imagine that of his fullness is completely giving you one grace, and after you have received this grace, he adds another grace.
Mukisa kyaine mu bujjuvu bwaina atuwa kisa n'atwongerako ekisa ku kisa.
It is like grace being added to grace received.
Kiringa okuwa ekisa n'akwongerako ekirala ku kisa ekyo.
As you receive this grace,
ng'otwala kino kyakuwadde,
he releases more grace.
N'akusumulirira ekirala.
As you receive it,
ng'okyayaniriza kino,
he releases more grace.
N'akwongera ekisa ekirala.
Is that not enough to turn you away from evil? Ekyo
tekikumala gwe wenenye ove ku kibi.
How about his love?
Ate okwagala kwe.
The love that caused him to come down on earth.
Okwamuleetera okuva eri okujja ku nsi.
The creator of the earth.
Omutonzi w'ensi n'eggulu.
To leave his lofty home above.
Ave eri mu ggulu gye yali.
Be born as a helpless baby in Bethlehem.
Azaalibwe omwana omuwere mu Beserekemu.
Suffer every shame.
Abeere mu nsonyi n'ebiswazibwa.
Suffer every mockery.
Aswazibwe avumirirwe.
Chased from city to city.
Nga bamugoba mu kibuga ayingira kirala.
Called a wine bibber.
Nga bamuyita omutamivu.
Called everything a friend of sinners.
Buli kigambo eky'okuvvoola.
Finally caught, betrayed, beaten and die.
Ne bamulyamu olukwe ne bamukuba n'afa.
Why? Because you and I deserve to die.
Kubanga gwe nange fa abagwanira okufa.
But he died in our place.
Ne yasalawo atufiire.
He took on the wrath of God.
N'atwala obusungu Katonda bwe yayina.
And satisfied the demands of heaven for justice.
N'asasula ebbanja ly'eggulu ery'obwenkanya.
All the judgments were placed upon him.
emisango jonna bajiteka ku ye.
He took all our iniquities
n'atwale kibi kyaffe
upon himself.
Kuye.
And he bids us to come to him.
Kata atwaniriza tujye.
All that are weary.
Bonaba kuye.
All that are heavy laden.
Bonaba zitoweredwa.
And he promises to give us rest.
Now tusubizo tuumuza.
Yet we reject that as well.
Abantu bakyegana.
Now if we have rejected the grace of God.
Woba uganye kisakatonda
cyane. If you have rejected the mercy of God.
Nogano kusashira kwa kuwade.
If you have rejected the wrath of God.
Nogano busungu bwa kuwade.
What is there for you to receive?
Osigaliza ki?
Except the judgment of God.
Okujja ke misango katonda jya kusalira.
So why the judgment of God?
Rache misango jya katonda.
Because the judgment of God.
Wange misango katonda jya sala.
Is targeted on the evil.
Ajisalira ababi.
Grace changes the heart.
Ekisakire tere mitimu okwenenya.
But judgment
na ye misango
ends evil.
Jikomya HIV.
It is judgment that removes evil. It is judgment that brings people to a reset.
Emisango je jireta abantu okuddayo kwetereza.
Judgment cleanses society.
Emisango jino jireta abantu okwetereza.
Judgment enables new beginnings to happen.
Emisango jireta abantu okudda bujja.
We see it all the way in the story of mankind.
Tuchilaba mu lugero lw'omuntu.
We see it when Noah went into the ark.
Noah wa yingira eliyato.
God's judgment was released.
Katonda nasumulure misango
je. And then what did we see?
Netulabachi.
We see a new beginning happening.
Tulabo okutandika buto.
We come to this point in time.
Kati mukaseera kano ketutuukako.
When you look at the journey of Israel,
walabo lugendo lwa Israel,
time and again you see the judgment of God.
Bisira binji katonda abasalire misango.
But you see that being marked with a new beginning.
Na ya atena abaddamu okutandika buto.
It is still the same cycle.
Tekikyukanga.
The judgment of God.
Emisango jya katonda.
This time when he says it is done.
Ne mukaseera ko wali ogera nti kikoleddwa.
The final judgment of evil will happen.
Emisango egyenkomeredde egy'ekibi giribaawo.
And at that point there will be no opportunity for people to receive grace.
Nga mukaseera ko tekyali mwaganya kuweebwa kisa.
There will be no mercy being shown to the people.
Takyasaasira bantu.
There will be nothing like the blessing of God.
Takyabawe mukisa.
It is the time
ke kaseera
when God's wrath and judgment will be poured out.
Ng'obusungu n'ekiruyi katonda byayina byokka.
You see, there is something I want you to understand.
When
we talk about the judgment of God,
many
of us can't relate a God of judgment and a God of evil as being this one and the same person.
Kisumbwa nnyo abantu nnyo okutegeera emisango n'ekisa Katonda nga Katonda y'omwagisala ate yatuwe ekisa.
But the fact is this, man left alone
omuntu ngali tayina buyambi
to his own wills
okwefuganga bwasalawo
to make his own judgments
okusalawo nga bwalowooza
is a recipe for disaster.
Awaba yingira kutabanguko nakusanyizibwa.
It is God's grace.
Okujjake
kisa chakato judgment that restrains evil.
Emisango jasala jejireta abantu okwetereza.
It is God's. Many people today are behaving because of the stringent laws that are in place.
Abantu beyisa bulungi ne mumpisa olw'amateeka agafuga.
But they fail to understand that there is a spiritual aspect.
Naye mulimu n'enkola
y'omuntu which holds people back, which holds evil back.
Waliwo ekyo ekiremesa obubi.
Otherwise, somebody you would not even be walking out or going out for a meal or walking by the roadside.
Singa kyekyo tewandibadde muntu afuluma mu nyumba ye.
Because men at their best
omuntu mumpisa zenu
without the spirit of God
gate wali moyo wa Katonda
a disaster
butabangu konagati abagamu
can happen
akola kyona kyasobola.
You will not be able to sit where you are and have your meal in peace.
Tewali to the one to wono kulye mmere yo mu mirembe.
You could not be watching TV or watching us right now as we're preaching this gospel.
The one is about the tula banga to kubuli the engineer.
The reason you are able to do so
is because
God is restraining evil.
And
for the people who will be here. When the church has gone away, the Lord will now experience what it means when the grace is withdrawn. When the hand of the restrainer is withdrawn. And every man does what they think is right in their eyes. I want you to think about this. And as we go, we need to understand this. That the judgment of God will come. Jesus says, "Behold, I am coming." Jesus is coming. And he is coming for the purpose of exposing everyone that does not have his righteousness. See, nothing is able to stand the judgment of God. The Bible tells us it is a fearsome thing to fall in the hands of a living God. So what do we see here? Here we will see, and later we'll expand in the subsequent lessons, that the wrath of God will be poured out on all those that have rejected Jesus Christ. On all those that have sided with the devil. On all those that have decided with the Antichrist and the false prophet. But what does that mean for you and I? Here we understand what we have been saved from. Here is where we understand what the love of God, what the favor of God, what the Spirit of God, what Jesus did at Calvary, and how it impacts our life. Because if it were not for Jesus Christ, you and I, this would be our destination. You see, it is one thing for you not to know what will happen. But here the Bible with all certainty paints the picture for you and me of what God is determined, of what God has decided to do as the age unfolds. So in spite of all the glamour that we see around us, in spite of all the beauty that we see, it may give us a picture of permanence. It may give us the impression that this is going to last forever. But I want you to understand, nothing that you see, however glamorous, however fortified it may be, is going to last forever. The one that will last forever is the one that has placed his life, or the life that will last forever is the life committed to Jesus Christ. So if you are here, I don't know what is going on in your mind right now. Possibly you think the people you believe have it all. They don't seem to have any cares. That's okay for now. But that is temporary. In the future, All that will pass away. If you are a student of history, you understand that empires have come. And empires have gone. Powerful men and women have come. And powerful men and women have gone. There is only one that is the same yesterday, today, and forever. His name is Jesus Christ. He is our strong foundation. He is the rock of ages. He is the one that can be trusted. That though the storms do rage, this rock will not rage. It will stand firm. No matter what happens around you, it will stand firm. A story is told of a man who was shipwrecked. So he got onto this rock and he held onto it. So later he was found. And then he was asked, when all this was raging around you, weren't you shaken? He said, yes, I was shaken. But the rock was not shaken. This is my message for you. You may be shaken by the events that are going on around your life, but there is a rock that is higher than you. This rock is Jesus Christ. His name, the Bible tells us, is a strong tower. The righteous run into it, and they are forever safe. If you are in the midst of the storm of your life, Jesus is that rock. Run to him. Hide in him. Be found in him. Not having your own righteousness. Be found in him. Having a righteousness that only he can give. No matter where you are in life, backslidden, unbelieving, the answer is Jesus Christ. No matter the state of life that you're in, the answer is still Jesus Christ. He is the one who came down. He is the one who took our place. And now he invites you into this relationship that begins now and extends to all eternity. Will you come to him? Will you receive him in your life as a personal Lord and Savior? Will you surrender to him everything? Because Jesus said, what will it profit a man after he has gained the whole world and loses his soul? Your soul is more important than your possessions. Your soul is more important than your status. Your soul is more important than every property that you have. Your soul is more important than anything you can imagine. Jesus is the only one that you can trust your soul with. By his Spirit, he will come and make everything new. He will teach you how to live in this mad world.
He will
teach you how to live in spite of everything that is going on around you. That's what he says in John 10:10. He talks about the thief when he narrates the comparison of shepherds. And he calls the other shepherd who is not him the thief. And he says he comes not but only to steal, to kill, and to destroy. That is his job description. But he says, I am come that they may have life and have it more abundantly. It is the life that flows from God. It is the life that God desires be yours, both on this side of eternity and on the other side of eternity. Therefore, if you have never received Jesus in your life as your Lord and personal Savior, this is your moment. The Bible says, narrow is the way, narrow is the gate that leads to eternal life, and there be few that find it. But there is a broad gate. There is a wide road that leads to destruction. And the Bible does not tell us whether men find it, because men are already on it. It is the narrow way that they need to find. Jesus is that narrow way, the only way to the Father. So will you surrender your life to him? Let's pray. Father,
Tata,
in the name of Jesus, I thank you for those that are watching us, for those that are listening to us today. I pray, Lord of glory, that by your Spirit, move, touch them, cause a change in their perception, move and eliminate their spirit, move and make a difference in their lives. For you who has not received Jesus, this is the moment when you ask, say, Lord, come into my life, wash away my sins, fill me with your Holy Spirit. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, Weberly,
for saving me. Thank you, Lord.
Mukama Weberly,
and my life is fully surrendered to you. Teach me to live for you. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. If you made that prayer, you have been saved. You see, it is not works. We are saved by grace through faith. So there is nothing, there is no ceremony about it. The Bible says we believe with our hearts, and we confess with our mouth, and we are saved. Just like that. You are now a child of God. Call that number on the screen. Somebody will receive that and give you the first instruction in this new work of the faith. For you, the believer out there, this is what you were saved from. The wrath of God is not upon you. The judgment of God is not upon you. You are the beloved of God. And it is your duty now to show humanity this way to receive life, this way to receive hope, this way to receive grace. And God richly bless you as you reach out to the lost and hopeless of this world with the saving gospel of Jesus Christ. So till next time, from Dominion Church, say shalom. God richly bless you. Amen.
Amen.